stuff in it. It's a bloody coat.
Order, please, ladies and gentlemen. I have much pleasure now in calling our old friend, Robert Scarce, to oblige with a small ditty, and I think the song will be When Paddy Stole the Rope.
It was of two Irish labouring men to England they come over. They went about in search of work from Liverpool to Dover. Said the Mick to Pat, I'm tired of that, and we shall both be left in the lurch. If we don't find work before the morn, we'll go and rob a church. What rob a church, said the Mick to Pat, how could you be so wild?
The order, then, gentlemen.
Well, something will surely happen while going down the aisle. If you'll go to an I will too, and get out both safe, we hope. Now if you all listen to my story, I will tell you how Paddy stole the rope. Now they broke into a country church where there was no one minding, and raking together all they could to see what they could find then. And raking together all they could, and when they got outside, oh, something strong and stout, my boys, for the bundle must be tied.
The order, ladies and gentlemen.
Now Paddy spied the church bell rope, and quick as a nimble oar, he scrambled to the belfry high to go and steal this rope. And holding on one leg and arm, when he pulled his clasp knife out, and right above his head so bold, he cut the rope so stout. Now, said the Mick to Pat, get out of that. Who on the floor lay groaning? If that's the way to steal a rope, just lend to me your knife. He scrambled to the belfry high, just like a knotful thief. But did he cut in it above? He cut it underneath. Now the rope fell down without a sound, and left poor Mick hanging. Oh, come and take me down, cry Mick, or else I drop, I die. For the noise on brought the people there, and when they got outside, if they ain't got no work to do, there's plenty now inside.
Good on you, Bob.